Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we are going to look at some more interesting examples of order of an element. Recall in the last lecture, we gave a formula for order of an element. So in the direct product, if I take an ordered n tuple, a1, a2, an, and if each one of these elements is of finite order in their respective groups, then we can say that the order of this element will also be finite, and we proved that it will be equal to LCM of R1, R2, Rn, where Ri happens to be the order of the ith element. So let's make use of this formula. I start with an easy problem. Let's look at the direct product of Z12 with Z60. And Z24. So in this direct product, I wish to find out the order of the triple 8, 4, 10. Now it is to be understood that when I write 8, it is the same as 8 bar, because in Z12, I have residue classes. So let's look at the order of 8 bar in Z12. Because this element is coming from the first group, that is Z12, the order of 8 bar will be 12 upon GCD of 12 and 8, which is 12 upon GCD of 12 and 8 will be 4. So 12 upon 4 is 3. So the order of the first element in the first group is 3. Likewise, let us find out the order of the second element in the second group, that is Z60. So in Z60, the order of 4, which is the same as 4 bar, will be 60 divided by GCD of 60 and 4. And GCD of 60 and 4 is 4. So 60 divided by 4 will give me 15. So the order of 4 bar is 15. And then let's look at the order of Z24, the order of 10. In Z24, order of 10 or 10 bar will be 24 divided by GCD of 24 and 10. GCD of 24 and 10 is 2. So this will be 12. So now I know the orders of the individual elements. Therefore, I use the formula that I gave in the last lecture. The order of this triple will be the LCM of the order of 8, order of 4, and order of 10 in their respective groups. And we have just now proved that the order of 8 bar in the first group is 3. The order of the second element in the second group is 15. And the order of the third element in the third group is 12. So all we need to do is to find the LCM of 3, 15 and 12, and that is going to be 60, I guess. You can check this. So the order of this element in the given group is going to be 60. Okay. Let's look at the next problem. So look at this next question. Find the maximum possible order for some element of Z4 cross Z6. Now let's first look at the group Z4. The order of Z4 is 4. And we know that for a finite group, order of every element is finite first of all, and the order of the element has to divide the order of a group, of its group. So the orders, the possible orders of elements in this group will be 1, 2, 4. So elements in this group can only have orders 1, 2 or 4. There cannot be an element of order 3 in this group. That's what I'm trying to say. Similarly, if you look at the group Z6, the order of Z6 is 6. So in this group, we can have possible elements of possible orders 1, 2, 3 and 6. So an element in the first group can have either order 1, 2 or 4. An element in the second group can have order 1, 2, 3 or 6. So, if I take an element A, B in Z4 cross Z6, to find out the order of this element, I will have to take the LCM of order of A with order of B. So, this is how I will be able to find the order of any element in this group. However, if I am looking for an element of maximum order, then I need to know for what combination will this LCM become the largest. So, I must take all possible combinations and see where I get the largest value of the LCM. I think I'll get it for the pair 4 and 6. So, LCM of 4 and 6 is 12, and therefore the largest possible order for an element of Z4 cross Z6 is 12. Of course, there's one thing worth thinking about over here. How do I know that Z4 will definitely have an element of order 4? Likewise, how do I know that an element of Z6 is definitely going to have an element of order 6? Well, that is because we know that Zn is a cyclic group, and we also know that the order of the cyclic group has to be equal to order of its generator. So, if this is going to be a cyclic group, it's going to have a generator, and the order of the generator is going to be equal to the order of this group. So, in Z4, there is definitely going to be an element of order 4. In Z6, there is definitely going to be an element of order 6. In fact, element 1 bar is definitely an element of order 4 in Z4, and 1 bar is an element of order 6 in Z6. This 1 bar is different from this. This 1 bar is the 1 bar that's coming from Z4. So, it will contain all multiples of 4, whereas this 1 bar is coming from Z6. So, it will contain all multiples of 6. So, anyways, if I look at the element 1 bar, 1 bar in this direct product, then it will be an element of order 12. And this will be the largest possible order for an element of this group, Z4 cross Z6. Okay. We'll do some more examples on the order in the next lecture. That's all for now. Thank you.